now?
Bam.
That's all.
Maybe more once I see how many hits we get.
Hi, I'm Glen Gould. I play Avery. He's the lead in a film called Charlie's Own. No, I don't play piano. It's a story about a washed-up native boxer who is looking for redemption in a way. The original title of it was The Redemption of Avery Stone, but they came up with Charlie's Own. So it's a story about two individuals. It's a story about Jan and Avery, and both of them trying to find their way through life and trying to find redemption in their own personal lives so that they can continue to become good, healthy people.
I've seen your fights online.
I know you need a second chance.
I was hoping we could talk.
What's it about?
A job.
She ran away from home when she was 15, and she fell in with very dangerous people. Please, get her out.
And the original scripts I read 2 years before we went to camera, it was quite a journey. It was like a road film, a road movie, and the characters, you know, the characters always had that emotional quality, that emotional range to them. And so when I read this, I thought, wow, great, this is like an action hero role where, you know, I can be a badass, I can be a Charles Bronson type character. And it really attracted me in that way. And one of the first things I said is, you know, I want to do all my own fight scenes if I can. I got pretty beat up through a lot of it, you know, from getting my foot nailed to the floor to being electrocuted to being tortured. The process was, it was a lot of fun because I had to do some training. I had to put on some weight. I trained under a Golden Gloves boxer here in Toronto at over at Florida Jack's, the boxing gym. The opening scene was a 22-minute fight scene, which we shot all night. And I think by the end of it, I was like, okay, Melski, one more. That's it. I'm so wiped out. I'm so cold. I'm physically exhausted. So yeah, it was physically exhausting. What I liked about the character is there was a wide emotional range with the character. He's got the hard side, you know, where he's the tough guy, and then he's got, you know, his soft side where you can see that he's very caring and empathetic for other people. So, you know, I really enjoyed that range and being able to explore that. So that's one thing I really liked about Avery, and that he was almost as cool as me. 1 shot in and around the Halifax Dartmouth area, so all those surrounding areas around there, right in Dartmouth, right in Halifax. It was all around that area. East Coast film. Well, it's a lot of fun. I mean, you know, Maritimers, we have a reputation for being very chatty, very hospitable. So you have an entire crew full of friendly, talkative people, which was really, really nice.
We got a problem!
Okay, I got her.
Drive north to Fall River.
Don't leave for any reason.
What are we doing here?
You do what I say.
I'm not doing anything you say, buddy, okay? Let's get that straight.
Amanda was a dream to work with. She was very, very delightful. I mean, I couldn't have asked for a better co-star. She gave, and I've said this before, she gave 150% off camera as she did on camera. And it was so nice to work with another generous actor. So she was just delightful. That's all I can say about her. Mike, I had a blast working with. He's a little aggressive as a director, which I really, really enjoyed, you know. And he just kept pushing me to give my best performance. Even though some days I was having a hard time on a personal level and couldn't quite bring myself to that performance level, but he pushed me past that. And, you know, I really... he spoke the same kind of lingo as me as well, which can be, I don't know, straightforward, straight shooter, which I really enjoyed. So I really enjoyed working with Mike Melski. Well, you know, I like in this film, like one of the things, I mean, and I've always said this before, is we don't always have in Canadian film, we don't always have music to help drive the film. There's a lot of where it's just dialogue and you don't hear anything. And I think, you know, that's one of the things that Mike really tried to tackle in this, is that, you know, with the use of music and, you know, creating that ambience underneath the scene, I really, really enjoyed that. And you know, I don't, you don't usually hear of too many Canadian films getting theatrical releases. So I think that's something that we need to strive towards. And as a Canadian audience and as Canadian filmmakers, that we need to push a little more to get our films out here in the mainstream theaters and to have these theatrical releases, because we spend so much money going to see American films in theaters, and we buy popcorn and nibs and pop and everything else, and it costs a lot of money to go out and enjoy a good feature film. So I think, you know, this is one of the things that I've always felt, is that we need to push and strive more to get our films out there with big theatrical releases within our own country, and you know, help our own economy a little bit. Hey Canada, which is the last great Canadian film that you saw?
You want her dead, why?
I won't bother to explain a complex situation that you won't understand.
I've still got her, so I better start understanding fast.
Think carefully about your next move. We have many resources.
There's some things that I need to tell you. These people own everything and everyone. Something I gotta do. Something big. You with me?
Might help with the negotiations.
Make sure you're ready.
Are you ready?
Everyone tries, but almost nobody makes it.
You! You just bought yourself a nightmare.